Using essential oils for a nail polish remover by Hot Pink Zebra Polish. Hi everyone, in today's video I'm going to be doing another hand saving video, kind of like the hand mask video that I did just recently. And so this one is going to be on making a nail polish remover with essential oils. And this essential oil set that I got, which is phenomenal by the way, just the amount and the variety of oils in it and the nice little bag is just great, from Laguna Moon, and I'll be showing you guys that a little bit more. And so this little how to not use any acetone or those common nail polish remover ingredients, it's isopropyl alcohol vinegar and a couple kinds of essential oils, and I'll let you guys know how it went. So I hope you guys like this little experiment I'm trying, and don't forget to click subscribe to see all my future videos as well.
So here's that set. Like I said, it comes with a really nice bag. It's got a really heavy duty zipper. It's two-sided. There's a little foam switcheroo thing so that the bottles themselves don't bang against each other. And there's 10, no wait, yeah, no, yeah, 10, oh goodness. There's 10 different kinds of oils in this case, in this set. And I'll put a link to it in the description box below. And you can go through and you can see all the different ones in there. One of them that I was really excited about is the chamomile one, because that's one of the first ones that new little babies can use after they're 3 months old that can help calm them. So we're going to see if Melody likes that one. And so a lot of these essential oils you can't use for kids at all or have them around it. So I was really excited because I didn't have chamomile before, but I now do. So we're going to see how she likes that. So now for the little recipe. So I have a fourth of a cup measuring cup, and I'm going to be pouring it about a third full with distilled vinegar, just plain white vinegar, the stuff that I use for cleaning all the time. So the reason I'm just pouring a third into the fourth of a cup is you don't really have to be exact on that. And it's 3 to 1. So just do a third, or 2 to 1 rather. So just do a third and then add 2 to 3 drops of orange, 4 to 6 of lemon, and then just 1 or 2 of the tea tree. The only downfall I would say with these essential oil bottles, other than other ones that I've used in the past, is that the dropper pours more than drops. So you really have to be quick and count fast. Otherwise, you're going to end up with way more oil than you want because they come out pretty quickly. So that's just something that you kind of have to keep in mind when you're using them. And it's kind of, a lot of them that I use, you almost have to shake them to get anything out of them, which I like because you have a lot of control over how much you're getting. But it does work, and you just have to be a little bit more careful. And then fill up the measuring cup the rest of the way with isopropyl alcohol. I'm using 91%, so that's a pretty high concentration. Just fill that measuring cup the rest of the way with that. So then that is your mixture. That's all that is in this. So then I'm going to be pouring that into a little, what I call a pudding bowl. Just a little bowl that I happen to just use for pudding. But pour that into your little bowl that will fit all 10 or all 5 fingers in there without leaving a whole bunch of extra space, because this recipe doesn't make a whole bunch, that if you have a large bowl, you're just going to end up having a whole bunch of extra, you know, just not going to work so well. But then soak that for 5 to 10 minutes. I did do the full 10, I mean. So I just wanted that to be known. I did the full 10 minutes and nothing happened. It didn't do a single thing, which was, I don't know if I want to say it was expected. I don't know. This is a recipe that I found on the internet, and it was kind of one of those things where I kind of wanted to myth bust it because it just didn't seem like it would work, and it didn't. So that's just kind of what I'd have to say about this. If you wanted to, you could definitely add those essential oils to your regular polish removers just to kind of make them a little bit more gentle and smell better for sure. But yeah, to use them on their own, not so much. So